and changing your position. Everything that is in the will of God this year is going to require us making some changes. This is our year of alignment. This is our year of order. In order for us to do what is being required of us, there's got to be some changes. But what I'm finding is that the more determined we are to change, the more opposition comes our way. Because the more you make up in your mind to fall in the alignment and the will of God, the more the devil will rear up his ugly head. Anybody know what I'm talking about?
Know what God says, but I also know what I see.
I know, amen, what God says. I know what he's promised me, but I also know how I feel. And if you're not careful, you'll begin to focus on what you see. Come on now, I'll give you trouble to talk to me. You'll begin to focus on how you feel, amen. If you're not careful, you'll begin to allow your negative to outweigh your positives. And before you know it, your thinking has reverted back. Amen, and change to what you used to think, how you used to feel. You start going back doing some of the stuff you used to do. You begin to go back saying some of the things you used to say. Our problem is that we normally speak what we see. We normally act how or what on what we see. We experience sickness and pain, and we speak negatively. We see our problems and we take up half the day talking about the negative, but we've got to get to a place where we begin to denounce negativity. Amen. We got to get to the place where we begin to change our vocabulary. I know what you see, but you got to change what you say about what you see. I know how you feel, but you got to change what you say about how you're feeling. I know what you've experienced, but you got to change what you say about it. That's why I told you this morning, give him an intentional praise in spite of what you see, in spite of how you feel, in spite of what's going through. You got to get to a place in your life where you begin to turn the tables on the enemy and make him out of the liar that he is. You got to change how you act. You got to change how you worship. You got to change how you praise. You got to change what you say. You got to remember that the Bible says life and death is in the power of your tongue. You have power. You're either going to speak blessings or you're going to speak curses. You're either going to speak faith or you're going to speak doubt. You're either going to speak victory or you're going to speak defeat. You're either going to speak abundance or you're going to speak lack. Life and death is in your tongue. What comes out of your mouth has great impact on what's going on around you. Somebody ought to start declaring right now, I'm still blessed. Somebody ought to start declaring right now, I will be healed. Somebody ought to start declaring right now, my children will be successful. Somebody ought to start declaring right now, I will live in prosperity. Come on, y'all, what's in your mouth? You got to begin to speak some things out of your own mouth. Amen. You can't wait for the preacher to say it. You start declaring it. You can't wait for the prayer warrior to pray it. You start praying it. Amen. You can't wait for the choir to sing it. You start bringing it out of your mouth. Come on, tell somebody, speak it. Instead of speaking words of doubt and discouragement and failure, amen, you need to change what you say and say what God says. Instead of worrying and talking about the problem, you need to speak the word and learn how to say what God says. If you want to come out from the place that you're in, you got to use the tools that God has already given you. If you want God to move on your behalf, you got to put the right words in your mouth. If you want to see your children set free, you got to put the words in your mouth. If you want to see your household delivered, you got to put the words in your mouth. If you want to see your ministry successful, you got to put the words in your mouth. Come on, somebody shout, change what you say. We know what God says. Amen. We read it in his word. Amen. He even drops it in our spirit. But then we allow what our flesh sees to talk us out of what we know God said. Amen, somebody. Amen. We're on a high. We're shouting about it. We're crying about it. We're blessing God for the revelation. And then when we see what we see, well, God, maybe I didn't hear you right. Well, God, maybe I was off.
Maybe that ain't what you said. Maybe that was just...
I said, if you're not careful, you'll let folk talk you out of what you know God has promised you. That's why you got to be careful who you hang around in this season. That's why you got to be careful who you allow to pour into your spirit in this season. You need folk around you that's speaking faith. You need folk around you that's speaking life. You need folk around you that's speaking positive. I ain't got time for nobody. Every time I look at you, every time I see you, you got something negative coming out of your mouth. I ain't got time for you. Every time I see you, you got a problem. You got a struggle. You got an issue. You got drama. I ain't got time for that. I got to hook up with somebody who going somewhere. Somebody say, if the Lord say so, I shall have whatever I say. Glory to God. If the Lord say so, I shall have whatever I say. If I say I'm rich, I shall have what I say. If I say I'm healed, I shall have what I say. If I say my family is saved, I shall have what I say. If I say my bank account is overflowing, I shall have what I say. Because at the end of the day, I believe the report of the Lord. His report says I'm healed. His report says I'm set free. His report says I'm on my way to a wealthy place. Somebody shout, I will have what I is true. I believe it because his word can't come back to him void. Somebody shout one more time, make the devil a liar, tell him I shall have what I say. Mark 22, Jesus said, have faith in God, for verily I say unto you that whosoever shall say to this mountain, be thou removed and be cast into the sea, and shall not doubt, but shall believe what he says, he shall have whatsoever he says. Listen, you gotta change what you say. You gotta change what you say in your household. I dare you to go back home this afternoon and walk through your household and declare, we gonna have what we say. This house will be paid for. Community will be delivered. No more drugs.